Hi everyone, I'm Sylvia Wakana and welcome back to my channel. I'm going to talk a little about New Year's. New Year's is one of the biggest and most important holidays in Japan. It's a holiday to spend with your family and loved ones, and their traditional Japanese New Year food called osechi ryori that you eat, and there's hatsumode, which is the first visit to shrines and temples to pray for good things for the new year. Osechi ryori is full of dishes that are symbolic to bring in luck for the new year and really is a beautiful spread. I'm not going into depth about all the osechi dishes this time, but I teamed up with Quarry Arctic to show you how to make a celebratory salmon butter chirashi sushi to share with your loved ones. While tai or snapper is most commonly eaten for osechi ryori, my family loves salmon, so we often eat salmon for osechi. Also, my mom always makes a big plate of chirashi sushi, which is like a sushi dish which has sushi rice on the bottom and scattered toppings on top. Chirashi sushi is often eaten as a celebratory dish in general, not just on New Year's. So I'm combining these two special family New Year's dishes to make a celebratory salmon butter chirashi sushi to ring in the new year. For the salmon, I will be using Quarry Arctic's salmon. Quarry Arctic is a sustainable salmon company located in Norway. I think the name is pronounced more like Quare, but that's a little bit hard to say. I don't even know if I'm saying it right, so they use Quare in American English. It's a family-owned company, and they are extremely forward-thinking when it comes to sustainable salmon farming. And they spend a lot on developing technology to make their practices even more sustainable and make the salmon's life and quality even better. Their salmon can be eaten raw or cooked, which is really great because a lot of salmon that you could buy in grocery stores are not good to be eaten raw. Highly recommend checking them out, so I will have links in the description. Also, while you're clicking around, make sure to subscribe to my channel and like this video if you like Japanese food and culture. Also, random fact, I heard like culturally or like how the people are, Norway is actually very similar to Japan. All right, let's get started. First, prep your ingredients. I'm cubing the Quarry salmon and tamagoyaki, cutting blanched snap peas at an angle, and trimming lotus root to look like a flower. Next, make sushi rice. I'll link the video and recipe for how to do this in the description. In a bowl or on a plate, put in your prepped sushi rice and then add on the toppings. Also adding on some ikura, which is salmon roe, and tobiko, which is flying fish roe. Plus adding some gold leaf for extra abundance. And you're done. Place on the table to share with your loved ones and itadakimasu.